The situation in Syria's Idlib appears to be once again on the brink of escalation, with the US preoccupied with what's happening at home and Turkey attempting to push towards Ayn Issa while being targeted by its own proxies. The terrorist threat is far from removed, and attacks are common. Moments of calm in the country's east and northwest appear to be far and few between. The situation that's transpiring is, to a large degree, due to Turkey's actions and its policies. Ankara, too, is suffering from it, since many of the groups that it backs, officially or otherwise, seem to be eager to bite the hand that feeds. On January 16th, Turkish troops in observation posts in Idlib were targeted by sniper fire from a group that calls itself Sayrat Ansar Abu Bakar al-Siddiq. According to the group itself, three Turkish soldiers were shot. One appears to be in critical condition. This is the group's third attack against Turkey, with the first taking place in November of 2020 and then in December of 2020. The December attack resulted in one Turkish soldier's death. Other reports of Turkish proxies attacking Ankara's armed forces occasionally take place. The Turkish military maintains more than 60 posts, camps, and bases throughout Greater Idlib. Most of them are located in terrorist-controlled areas, and attacks on them are rather infrequent due to Ankara's close ties with terrorists operating in the area. Nonetheless, as the recent attacks show, this policy has some weak sides for the Turkish personnel deployed. Ankara is attempting to encroach near the Syrian Democratic Forces, SDF-controlled area, attempting to establish an observation post near Ayn Issa. A push on SDF positions is expected, but there will be a defense.